Now, you can also use for loops to access elements of a matrix or of an array. We'll use it for an array since that's just one for loop instead of two. But what we're going to do is we're going to look at how we use a for loop to add individual elements of an array. So you can say, well, I know how to do this because I'm just going to say sum of A. And be like, yeah, I know, that's the right answer. But let's pretend that we didn't have this. And if you were programming in any other language besides MATLAB, pretty much, well, maybe. In a lot of different programming languages, you would either have to import a special header file that has this stuff in it, or you would have to write your own function that would do this. So basically what we're going to do is we're going to create a for loop that would add the values of this array. So actually, I'd like you to give it a shot and see if you can figure out how to do it on your own. So pause the video, spend a little bit of time with it. If you're just totally stuck, then come back. Okay, so we're going to assume that that happened. I know that there are five elements in my array. I could generalize it, but for the moment, I'm just going to leave it. So I'm going to say I'm going from 1 to 5. Okay. I don't have to use the word index. I just like it because it helps it make sense. So basically, we're going to do very similar to what we did whenever we used a for loop to just add numbers, but now we're going to add specific numbers. So whenever we're adding numbers, most of the time, it's a good idea to start with initialization of 0. So I'm going to call this loop. I'm going to initialize that to 0. And the reason I'm going to initialize it to 0 is that every time I'm going to add a number, I want to originally add it to 0. So you're going to, if you're doing something over and over and over, if you're increasing a value, then generally what you're going to see is some kind of a structure that looks like this. So bug equals bug plus, and I want to use the, so the first time I go through, I want the first element of A, then I want the second element of A, third element of A, and so on and so forth. So literally all I need to do is I need to say A at index. And believe it or not, that's all you need to do this. So we start off with bug being equal to 0. And as we run through it, when index is 1, it's going to go 0 plus. So I'm going to write this out. So bug is 0. And then index is 1. And whenever index is 1, bug is going to equal to the current value of bug plus a at the index. The index is 1. So 0 plus a1 is 0 plus 8. So it's 8. The second time I go through, index is 2. So bug is equal to current value of bug, which is 8, plus a at the current index. The index is 2. So it's 8 plus the current value at a at 2, which is 12, and that's 20. Okay. So again, if maybe you couldn't get the for loop, if you couldn't get the for loop, then it's really, really, really important that you pause the video and see if this makes sense. So go through all five steps just to make sure that you're understanding what's going on, especially if you couldn't write the for loop from scratch. The way you're going to get good at it is by practicing and doing stuff like this over and over. Okay, so I'm going to pretend that you pause the video because, you know, learning is important. So I've got bug is going to equal the previous value of bug, or the current value, which is 20, plus a at the current index. So 20 plus 57, which is 77. All right. Then when index is 4, I'm going to say that bug is the current value of bug plus a at the current index. So 77 plus 19, which is some, I don't know, 96. I guess I could have done that. 96. I just don't want to get that wrong. And then index is equal to 5. Then bug is equal to the current value of bug plus a at 5, which means 96. Plus 8, 5 is 23, so 96 plus 23 is 119. So I hope to get a value of 119 whenever I run this. I'm going to run it. I can't tell what I did because it's way over there. Okay. So whenever I run it, I get bug starts out at 0, then it goes to 8, 20, 77, 96, and 119, which is precisely what I expected it to do. So I got the total sum of the elements of the index as 119. So that's very, very exciting. Here's another idea though. Let's say that instead of doing what we just did, let's say that we want to add like each pair of elements in the for loop. So instead of saying I want to add 8 and then 12, I want to like add 8 and then add 8 and 12 and then add a 12 and 57. 57 and 19, and 12 and 13, I guess. Let's just say I want to add them by pair. So I want to add this one, and then I want to add these two, and then I want to add these two, and then I want to add these two. Okay? So this is going to be a little bit more complicated. And what I like to do is I'd like to just display. I'm just going to display it. So my display should look like, this is not how I want to look. My display should look like, it should say 20, and then it should say 69, and then it should say whatever, 59, 57, 19. And then it should say 76, and then it should say whatever 19 and 23 is. It's 42. Okay, so I just wanted to say, I just want to display it to screen. I don't want to store it or anything like that. So let's see how far we can get on this. So I just want to add the pairs of the elements within the loop. So whenever I do this, I have to think, okay, well, do I want to think about starting with 8 and going to 19, so 1 to 4, or do I want to go 2 to 5? And it really just depends on your outlook on life. I am personally going to go from 1 to 4 because I like adding numbers instead of subtracting. So what I'm going to do is, all I'm going to do is every time I run through, I'm going to take A at the current index, and I'm going to add A to the index of the next one. That's it. That's all I need to do to make this work. So check this out. So I got 20, then I got 69, then I got 76, and then I got 42. So I have A at the current index plus A at the current index plus 1. So the reason I didn't go to 5 is because whenever index is 5, it'd be 5 plus 1 is 6, and I don't have 6 elements in my array. So if I run this, it yells at me. So that is a hint that I could go to 4. Now I said if you wanted, you could actually go count down, or from 2 to 5. And if you're going to go 2 to 5, then you would have to go, like, I'd probably say index minus 1 plus A at the current index. So when index is 2, it'd be 1 plus 2 and 2 plus 3 and 2. So when index is 5, it'd be 5 here and a 4 here. And I get the same display. I personally, like I said, it just freaks me out just a teensy-weensy bit more, just enough that I would rather add. Okay, now I really want to blow your mind. Let's actually store these values. So I'm going to call, what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to do this. I'm going to say, you know, bug at index. And I want you to see what this is going to do. Okay, so this is slowly going to create a matrix or an array called bug, where it is going to store the addition of each pair of elements, so 20, 69, to 76, to 42. Okay, so I'll kind of walk you through what it's going to do. So when index is equal to 1, it's going to say bug at 1 is going to be equal to A at 1 plus A at 1 plus 1. Sorry, 1 plus 1. So whatever that is. So 8 plus 12, and that's 20. All right. Then index is going to be 2. So it's going to say bug at the current index, which is 2, is going to be equal to A at the current index plus A at the current index plus 1. So that'll give me the 12 plus 57, which is 69, and so on and so forth. So this is something that you also see happen a lot, is storing outputs into an array that you kind of create on the fly. Now, it's actually yelling at you because it says it appears to change size on every loop iteration, which is true. Consider reallocating for speed. I'm not really worried about that right now. I'm just trying to teach you for loops. So I can do that. Another thing that I can do to achieve the same thing, and this is a little weird, so I'm going to put it here. This is just a little bit different, that you can actually use the end statement. So I say, well, instead of doing it at the current index, just do it at the end of wherever bug is. Now, the first time I do it, it's going to yell at me because it says there is no such thing as bug. And in this case, I would have to initialize bug to a blank matrix. So I can initialize bug to a blank matrix and say, do it at end, I think I need to do it at end plus 1. Yeah. So I could say do it at wherever bug is, go to the end of it, and add a term. So these two things actually do the same thing. Personally, I'm kind of going to go with this guy because it's a lot more obvious of what's happening. That said, sometimes this is the way you've got to go, to start out with the blank matrix and slowly add to it.